Hello and welcome to day 4 of Virtually 30. Today I am showing Bigscreen Beta. I actually started recording this from the interior of Bigscreen Beta. So just to take a look around, we got some curved screens here, which is kind of comfy for VR. I have this little flat panel that shows chat rooms that you can join. They're a little more than chat rooms, they're actually VR spaces that are shared with other players. So mics are on. You can use hand gestures. It's pretty interesting, and I think you can join those on desktop too, but I'm not 100% sure on that. And I have just an extra desktop screen there, and then this nice, you know, open floor plan apartment, I guess. I can't remember. It's been a while since I tried Big Screen Beta out, and the last time I did it, I was on an HTC 5, so... things feel about the same, but it looks like there are a couple differences too. All right. So let's take a look at some of the navigation in here first. We have something to just control the placement of the screens and the size. This is, I think, the distance. Yeah, so you just kind of aim up or down with that, which seems to work pretty well. So how close can we get the screen to us? Still a bit far off. But you can reach out and grab things with the grip button, which is kind of nice. So this little panel that shows the rooms you can join works the same way. That's a very natural feeling interaction for VR. Let's make this a little bigger and move it a little back and control the curvature. So if you like them straight and planar or more quadratic, there you go. I think, yeah, so this is actually something that lets you toggle the VR mode. So you'll get a different picture in the left and right eye with that. That's over under, side by, and that's side by side. That's over under, and that's just VR, I guess. I think, yeah, that just toggles display on the the home theater center behind you. So this is kind of a nice feeling, too. You get the projector, comfy living room experience no matter where you are. I definitely don't have this much floor space or furniture. So I am going to... Wow, it's been a while. Bring up my avatar customizer. Let's give me something representative. This mirror mode is interesting. Weird shirt. Plain blue. There we go. That's okay, I guess. So the mirror mode is pretty impressive. Look, it's getting the OBS window behind me, which has the tunnel vision effect, of course. This means lots of nice techniques like deferred rendering, and that makes me happy. More shirts, I guess, that aren't loaded or previewed. This is a weird level of avatar creation, because I think you have to take these and like put them on your face, right? Yeah, just get that on my lips. Why didn't that change? Okay, eyebrows. Give me something pencil thin, yeah. And yeah, naturally give me these beautiful green eyes. Put them right on my face. Oh geez, I'm not sure that's better. And I just got beautiful green eyes, so I don't think I want to cover them up. Mohawk looks cool, but... I'm going to go with this. So change your color with just a dip. That is very natural feeling. Too bad you can't get a shade in between. Green hair for the green eyes. Voila. Face shape. Face color. Yeah. All right. I think that's it. There we go. back to these. I don't even know if, oh, this is the shape, right? Wow. Okay. I can give myself ample chest. The pecs that I never had. Too bad I can't turn to the, oh, a little bit of side turn. That's it. Yeah. Yeah. Nah. Let's go with a good old triangle shape. Let's jump into Spider's room. That's a bottle cap. What the hell is this movie? This is the weirdest. Oh my god. What am I? Sorry, what movie is this? Yeah, I see that. Well, that's the fun of social VR, the watching stuff together. I've never done streaming parties where I was just at my desktop or laptop on, you know, voice chat with other people watching the same thing, but doing that in VR does feel a lot more, I guess, natural, and I think it's really just you look over and someone's sitting next to you, and as long as everyone's well behaved, that's not a bad thing. So I don't know, I think, I mean, I feel like I wouldn't have gotten that weird experience going in somewhere else. Oh yeah, since I'm here, and I'm using the Rift controllers, still showing the hands, it's a time to show off some of the poses, so thumbs up, pointing with the thumb up, soft grip, slight grip, yeah, slightly expressive, okay, cool. So you got thumbs up, and okay if you're American, and I think that's about it. Yeah. All right, so in the interest of trying out this pop-up keyboard, let's go to here and let's try. Oh no, I grabbed it by mistake. Let's try. Dark Souls, nice. Yes. Cool. So, I mean, this works pretty well. This would be, I think, really handy if it just had, like, the swipe interface, though. So, just dragging and getting the line across to do, you know, like, big screen space beta would probably be the fastest, easiest keyboard I've seen in VR, because a lot of them are just like this, where you're, you know, back to touch typing again, and we have something that does work and is accepted pretty widely on mobile, so I think it would be better than just this. Yeah, so environments, the void. I haven't been to the void in a while. This was my first choice for VR environments. There's nothing. It's absolutely nothing. Let's see. Grand Theater. Again, having the big screen for big screen beta is always kind of nice. Let's try campfire. Yes. A night out in nature with Dark Souls on a, what is that? 20 yards wide screen. It's awesome. Just standing up in the middle of the sky. Honestly, I'm into that. Let's turn off some of these screens. Let's see, how do I turn off some of these screens? There we go, there's one. That looks like a texture convergence point. So anyway, thanks for watching. That's Bigscreen Beta. I'll be doing more social VR programs on the next couple of days, and then we'll go on to something new. But thanks again. Bye. Hi-ya.